First up tonight, well, earlier today there were some pretty strange goings on in Queensland. Speaking as a Queensland-born lad, in itself that's not unusual. What it is further proof that we are living in an age of, how to put it, unusual politics. The Queensland opposition leader and his deputy both quit today, muttering something about treachery. Why? Well, Brisbane's Lord Mayor, Campbell Newman, whom we saw almost as much of as the politically resurrected Anna Bligh during the floods, has announced he's taking a tilt at state politics. Not just state politics, but state premier. Some observers are saying this effectively makes Mayor Newman opposition leader Newman, and he's not even faced a parliamentary election. Here's political editor Hugh Rimmington.
In Queensland's flood crisis, Brisbane's Lord Mayor Campbell Newman shifted his share of the mess. Today he threw in the trash the leader of his own party, John Paul Lambrook.
It's a treacherous business and it's just what comes with the job of politics.
Mr. Lambrook today stood down as Liberal National Party leader in Queensland, also quitting his post, his deputy, former opposition leader Lawrence Springbaugh.
This is an extraordinary set of circumstances which we've never seen before. Other people have decided to chart this course. It is now for them to explain the practicalities of how it's going to work.
Both men have been swept away by the ambitions of the Lord Mayor.
And I'm offering myself as a potential premier for the people of Queensland.
But he admits his plan is a high-risk play.
I understand the complexities of this.
Mr. Newman now becomes leader in waiting, but because he's not in Parliament, the party will be officially led by the manager of opposition business, Jeff Seeney, who has swung his support entirely behind the new arrangement.
What does the LNP stand for, Mr. Speaker? They are in an absolute mess.
So what hope does this plan have against a premier reborn during Queensland's summer of horrors?
We are Queenslanders. We're the people that they breed tough north of the border.
Anna Bligh's widely admired leadership in the crisis saw her poll figures go from near terminal to a buoyant 60% approval, but Labor itself got less of a kick-up. A Galaxy Courier Mail poll last month showed the Liberal National Party holding a 10-point lead, enough to make Mr. Langbrook the premier. But secret coalition polling done without Mr. Langbrook's knowledge showed under Campbell Newman there would be no race. The Conservatives would win in a canter.
The people of Queensland are crying out for a change in direction. They're crying out to get the show back on the road. And Campbell's the can-do man.
It's all uncharted country. The betting markets initially firmed behind Labor, although now they're mixed. John Paul Langbrook complained about his party's faceless men, while here in Canberra, the federal opposition leader is steering well clear.
I think that matters internal to the coalition should be decided in Queensland.
Tony Abbott's own personal approval has taken a dive this year. In the latest news poll, his dissatisfaction rating is 21 points higher than his approval rating, a gap three times worse than Julia Gillard's. Not that anyone's talking of a move against him.
If we had a bit more, I'd say it must be the sun.